Hello and welcome to a kick-ass episode of Battle for Middle-Earth 2, Two Towers Are Not Enough. In this one, we have a surprising three-player free-for-all, obviously. Here, we've never tried this map before, but I think it's pretty cool, actually. So here we have myself, Jimbo. I went random as Mordor. And then up here we have Jackson. And down here we have Lewis as custom Isengard. So not a very long game, but it's kind of surprising actually, because I think probably a three player could go on for a long time, because if you attack someone, then that other person attacks you, and there's pretty much fuck all you can do about it. Alright, so Jackson's using his eye to get a good look of what's around him. Alright. Alright, so we kept it there now. Lewis, I wonder if he's got the... Yeah, Lewis went straight for the Murder of Crows. This is a good idea. I wonder how far can he see. Right. Well, I'll tell you what, you can't necessarily see my base, but you can see pretty damn far, like into my base if I start building out, that's for sure. And you'll be able to see an attack coming a mile away. So that's good. I like this as well, lava moat, to prevent anyone from trying to berserker rush, which is Lewis, and I would argue as well Carl. Carl has adopted a similar sort of thing as well with the old berserker rush, but there are ways to defeat it if you're prepared. But that's the whole point of the berserker rush, is that you go after someone when they're not prepared. Hi ho! But yes, getting my troops out. Got my Nazgul, yeah. Level one. Actually, I probably should have been sending this guy to go and get all the creeps. But Lewis here, he will be doing good. Oh god. Jackson. Chasing down a bloody builder. Stop moving the builder, stop moving the builder. Oh, and he got the money. Oh, bastard. Oh. Oh, bastard. Well, if he had killed the builder and got the money, that would have been an absolute piss take. I'm not sure if you need to take this thing out, Lou. I think you just take it. So you can see further. And also this thing helps to, decrease the power recharge time. So yes, that might have been helpful if you had that. Alright. He's getting all the creeps. That's good. Now I've decided to get the creeps. So yeah. Alright. I think he's decided to bugger off, because I've sent some pikeys. And we all know how dangerous pikeys are to Nazgûl. Right, Lewis has already got a tower up. He's almost effectively walling this area off. And my builder went astray. It's quite a forward line as well, that is pretty close. Jackson having another look. He's got his orcs. He's got a mixture of everything. Orcs, pikeys, the lot. So he's going to help get this. Everyone seems to be coming my way here. Doesn't seem to be any action here. Right, I see that there are towers going up, and I think, yep, siege straight away. Not having towers put around me, thank you very much. Alright, now I think Jackson's playing it well, so that he could have attacked but I think I might have had enough here to repel him. Interesting. Everyone seems to be beefing up their defences against me here. Right. Now, Lewis, you're doing one in each, I hope. That's good. Now that is a pretty solid defensive position. That would take quite a lot. I'd have to have a lot of siege to get through there. So, that's already... Lewis has almost sort of closed this off. Ooh, does he get in this time? Oh, he had a lucky escape. Oof, he is very, very lucky. Interesting. Out coming the catapults. That's a good thing with Mordor, they are pretty cheap. Alright, it's gone over here. Got spaced out. Jackson's moving out. No one's taking this, I'm surprised. Lewis, you gotta take this thing, man. If you take that, you'd be able to see quite far, you'd be able to see everything. Even further with current murderer crows. So I think Jackson's sort of putting his troops right in the middle just in case an attack comes from myself or from Lewis. That's a pretty good idea. Ah, he's got a Mathaserin. Alright, so now he's got a bit of support. He's got the Dread Visage, which is pretty good. Let's see if they take this thing out pretty well. Oh yeah, Mathaserin does actually pretty damn good damage, actually. Impressive. Pikes. Yeah, he's getting a bit closer. I don't know, Lou, maybe I think you need to have like a couple of... a bit of a line along here, but obviously you're going to need a lot more towers along here than you would here. There's sort of a choke point here, isn't there? I guess he can't have Jackson just running around his base. I don't know, do you... There's a lot of... yeah, a lot of these ready. I wonder, I think maybe Wargs might have been a pretty good idea if he comes at you again with these and you can't chase him. Yeah. Probably a good idea, but I mean, you'll probably like even go in like through here or something like that, you know, so you'd have to tower up a lot, but even so, the two of them will just run right past them. But it is quite a gauntlet that they'd have to kill. Oh no, oh no. More pikes, I think. More pikeys. Alright, so I got me lumber mills. Getting out a decent amount of siege. See, Jackson is ready. Jackson is ready. But I must admit, I did not go for the eye. I went for the tainted terrain. So, with that in mind, I'm sort of ready for a fight rather than seeing something. So, yes. But, I've certainly got enough of a force. Alright. Alright, he's taking out me lamp and me slaughter hares. I should have cancelled that. Silly from me. Alright. He's moving over now. That's just chasing him around the map. That is interesting. Oh, he's not going to lose Lurtz, is he? No. Right. I've sort of moved into position a little bit. I would have liked to have had a little bit more defenses and all that sort of thing here, but sometimes when you gotta go, you gotta go. Can't wait around too long. Interesting. Alright, what's Lewis doing? Alright, he's got pikeys, towers are going up. And a barracks there as well, just to make sure. Lewis is making this, this is a quite a demilitarized zone here, between here and here. It's a nice open space. Alright, he's trying to get in. Now, I was trying to avoid these being seen by these two. Because otherwise, if he can see that, he can see what I'm up to. And I think he is. He is aware. He is aware. Right. And here we go. I would have liked to have had a better hero, I must admit. I think if I had had the Witch King or something, that could have been pretty handy. Right. Here we go. Here we go. Right, tainting the terrain. A shitload of these. Jesus. Pretty devastating. Pretty devastating. I wish I would have had more upgrades actually on these guys before I'd gone in. See, these guys are taking a while to take out, just a few of them. These guys got a better chance. Probably went a bit too far there, I think. He has got the catapults out. That's probably my Nazgul that's gone. I really should have played this a bit better. But yeah, eventually protecting these things. Yes, those are under attack, but there's also two here that he's forgotten about. Yes, goes down, it's going down. Oh, I tell you what, Lou, if you'd palanted and seen what's going on, he's going to lose it. He lost his fortress. There's only four buildings, keeping him in the game now. Damn you builders. I'm sure he's got some builders like somewhere around. Alright. Got more barracks. Probably should have done this before, to be honest, bit shitty play for myself. I should have been building a little bit quicker, had this all ready to go. But I think Jackson has recovered, and I didn't really attack his troops too much. I just went for his fortress. So now that he is fortressless, I don't think that helps him. It's certainly not necessarily crippled him, but certainly not helped. Yeah, but these guys are wandering around the base, trying to search for some builders. I didn't remember that. I was just trying to search for a couple of builders. If I saw them, I was going to go for them. Yeah. Yeah. They just didn't do enough. Oof. What a shot. Saved them. Right. Now, Lewis, being the opportunist, went in. Well. Oh, this is... Oh, right. I was going to say, this is just... This is your attack. Well played. Lewis choosing the opportune moment. I think this is probably the best way to go, I would have thought. I mean, you could... Lewis could have gone in and finished off Jackson. But then, I think probably going after me is probably a little bit better. Alright. So, I have got my troops. But they are far too late in coming out. I should have already had a force. So yep, pretty shitty play for myself, and now I think Jackson, wanting revenge, has decided to sort of come in and thinking like to counter-attack. I think it's a bit ballsy, I think, because if you have lost your fortress and you have, and you're still rebuilding it here, which probably cost him a, you know, everything he had, yeah, everything he's got. I've got enough. Yep, Lewis has got enough. So I'm sure Jackson didn't really need that right there to lose his fortress. But yes. Right, for some reason I decided to get this fucker back out. Okay. And then this. Killed my own troops. Right, this is a good sustained attack. Can Jackson see what's going on here? Not really. Well, now I think he can. Yeah, he can't really see. Fortress going down. Nothing you can do about it. Billy Ballista's on it. Nothing you can do. Just nothing. Right. I think. Yeah, this is interesting. So it's sort of like, right, I'm going down, that's for sure. But who is going to be the one between Lewis and Jackson to fight each other? I think Lewis here, already sensing what's going on here, has decided to pull back. Yeah. Pull back and hopefully get some troops coming out here, Lou. You need those troops out there stat quick. And you need to hope that Jackson takes his time in trying to take me out. You need to hope that I sort of don't completely capitulate here. And that guy's just sitting around doing nothing. Five ballistas. That's all you need in life. If you've got five ballistas, that's all you need. Alright. Get more troops. Need some more troops. Get these all these fuckers involved. Here we go. Here we go. Right. Lewis is ready. Right. He's upgrading that as well. Jackson. Taking his time. Is he taking too much time in trying to see what's going on? I am no longer a threat. Don't even have a builder. Lewis, random crossbow, stick him in here. Right. Alright, I do have a builder. I guess I really did give up. Or did I? Now, I think Jackson sees the danger. Not even Minas Morgul here is going to help him. Lewis has gone straight for the jugular. He's gone straight in. Fuck all the other buildings. Look at those orcs doing almost no damage whatsoever on this bloody ballista. Fortress going down for a second time. Wildman here. There's nothing he can do. Jackson pulls back, but it's all over. It's too late. It's too late. Pike is. He's starting to get the upgrades. There's nothing Jackson can do if Lewis has all the upgrades for all of his troops. They're just no match. Slowly but surely. Have you got any reinforcements, Lou? Alright, okay. Reinforcements. Push home the attack. Going in. He's even got troops randomly sitting by doing nothing. I think Jackson was hell-bent on getting revenge for me taking out his fortress, which in the end I think cost him. But I think, obviously, I'm pretty sure Lewis, obviously, being able to see what's going on everywhere had a huge effect. Oh wow, even pauses the heroes as well. Yeah, that's interesting. You don't need him on bow stance. This is all he wrote. All that money. And Jackson out. Jackson is out. Stay in formation. and I basically sent. I did actually think that Jackson needed to be attacked, so I thought I send another force to try and repel Jackson, and that was about it. But Lewis is not taking any chances. That's for sure. He wants to make sure he wins this. Right, where's his Billy Ballistas? Right. Right, more and more Pikeys. There are a shitload of Pikeys. Got me hemmed in. Nothing you can do. The stench of death is upon me, that's for sure. Sending out my troops in a Faramir attacking Osgiliath sort of last ditch effort. Got the upgrades. Is there anything more vicious than that? Upgraded Isengard Pikeys, which are doing shitloads of damage, and you just know you can't fuck around with them. Nothing you can do. I know, Lewis, I think you should get Lurtz in here, because then he's got the plus 50% damage. So therefore, if he's here, these guys are all going to be glowing yellow, and they'll do 50% more damage. But Lewis doesn't even care. He can, like, watcher his own troops. Who gives a shit? Right, the Billy Ballistas are here. Nothing you can do. All I see is just pikes. It's like a fucking hedgehog over here. Nothing you can do. What are you going to do? Run over them? Even Army of the Dead isn't hard enough to take this out. And the game is over. And I think this is one of only a couple that Lewis has won here. And I tell you what, if there's one game that you want to win, it's definitely a three-player. Because I think the three players are probably some of the hardest games to try and win. Just to make sure on this Orc Pit. You never know, I could bounce back. Well played to Lewis. Well played, good game, very tactical. I hate the three players because the person who attacks usually ends up being screwed over. It can be that easy. But yes, well played to Lewis. Catch you in the next one, boys.